Hello students, welcome back to the session. In this session, let us derive an expression for electrical conductivity of a conductor. Next is expression for electrical conductivity. Expression for electrical conductivity. Electrical conductivity. Electrical conductivity. This electrical conductivity generally will call it as a sigma here. Whether given material is a good conductor of electricity or bad conductor of electricity is decided by the factor electrical conductivity. Say for example, if copper is a good conductor as compared to aluminium. Suppose if copper is a good conductor as compared to aluminium, it indicates that copper has maximum value of electrical conductivity. Copper has maximum value of electrical conductivity as compared to what? Aluminium. Insulators are the bad conductors of electricity. Insulators are the bad conductors of electricity. Metals are the good conductors of electricity. Obviously, metals should have high value of conductivity as compared to what? Insulators. High is the conductivity, greater will be the what? Conducting property of a material. Or else the material is said to be good conductor of electricity, provided it should have the high value of what? Electrical conductivity. Then how you are going to define electrical conductivity of a given material? As I said in the last class, reciprocal of resistivity is called conductivity. Reciprocal of resistivity is called conductivity. What is electrical conductivity of a material? The electrical conductivity of a material is simply, it is a reciprocal of resistivity. We'll call it as a electrical conductivity. Then mathematically what I can write? Sigma can be written as 1 by rho. The sigma can be written as what? 1 divided by rho. Sigma is equals to 1 by rho. Further, SI unit of what? Resistivity is ohm meter. I will extend my discussion. 1 divided by SI unit of resistivity is ohm meter. SI unit of resistivity is ohm meter. So, SI unit of conductivity is 1 divided by ohm meter. 1 divided by ohm meter means 1 by ohm. We will call it as a mho. 1 by ohm, we'll call it as a mho here. Mho is equals to 1 by ohm. Mho is also called Simon. Mho is also called Simon. Concentrate on the terms here. 1 by ohm, reciprocal of ohm is called mho. It is represented by this symbol. That's mho is also called Simon. Okay. Then 1 by ohm is equals to mho per meter. What is mho per meter? Mho per meter is called SI unit of what? Conductivity. What is the SI unit of conductivity? Mho per meter. As I said you, mho is also called Simon. If mho is called Simon, the another unit of what? Another unit of electrical conductivity is Simon per meter. Mho per meter or Simon per meter is the SI unit of what? Electrical conductivity. In the first step, you just concentrate on what? Definition of what? Conductivity and its SI unit. Tell me what is the definition of conductivity? Reciprocal of resistivity is called conductivity. Reciprocal of resistivity is called conductivity. its SI unit is mho per meter or Simon per meter is the SI unit of what? Electrical conductivity. Okay. Now let us derive an expression for electrical conductivity. Let us derive an expression for what? Electrical conductivity. For that, let me consider conductor of certain length L. Consider a conductor or conducting wire of certain length L. Across this conductor, potential difference V is applied. V is a potential difference or voltage applied. As a result, what happens? The current will start flowing through a conductor. What is I here? I is a current which is flowing through a conductor. The reason for flow of current in a conductor is flow of what? Number of free electrons in a conductor. Therefore, I will define N. What is N? Number of free electrons per unit volume of a conductor. We will call it as a N. Due to flow of these free electrons, current will start flowing through a conductor. Reason for flow of these free electrons is they are experiencing electrostatic force due to the presence of what? Electric field. Ilen potential difference in apply martire. Suddenly electric field generate agutte across the conductor. Electric field generate agkudle conductor nalliruvanta free electrons ge force act agutte. All free electrons in a conductor, they start experiencing a force. As a result, free electrons in a conductor starts drifting from one end of a conductor to what? Another end of a conductor with velocity. That velocity will call it as a drift velocity. All free electrons one end of a conductor in the inner end of a conductor again flow ugly start aktade. With what velocity? With a velocity called what? Drift velocity. When a free electron starts moving through a conductor, definitely the current will start flowing through a conductor. Let me recall the expression here. Therefore, current in a conductor is given by, current in a conductor is, what is the expression for a current in a conductor? Already we derived. I is equals to N A E into V. Concentrate here. What is N? Number of free electrons in a conductor. Number of free electrons per unit volume of a conductor. A is called area of cross section of a conductor. E is called, what is E? E is called charge of electron. What is V? Drift velocity of what? Free electrons in a conductor. Drift velocity of what? Free electrons in a conductor. Okay. Next is, let me recall the expression for the drift velocity. We know that. What is the drift velocity of free electrons? We know that the drift velocity of free electrons is given by Vd is equal to small e into capital E divided by M into tau, where tau stands for relaxation time. Here tau stands for what? Relaxation time here. I can substitute the value of drift velocity here. If you substitute the value of drift velocity here, I can write I is equals to what? NAE into the value of Vd is given by small e capital E by M into tau. Okay, I have substituted the value of what? Drift velocity. Then continue the expression. I is equals to NA as it is, E into E, E square. Next is small e into tau divided by what? M. Okay. Further, I will transfer A to the LHS. Area of cross-section of a conductor, I will transfer to the LHS. I can write I divided by A is equals to. I divided by A is equals to. What I can write? N A E square capital E tau by M. Okay. Sorry, already I have transferred A here. A comes to the LHS. Already we defined I divided by current per unit area of cross section of a conductor. Current per unit area of cross section of a conductor, we will call it as a current density. And this current density is denoted by what? J. I by A is equals to what? J. Therefore, what I can write? J is equals to N E square E tau by A. Further, we have J is equals to what? Sigma into E. Already we derived J is equals to what? Sigma into E. Therefore, sigma into E is equals to what? N E square E tau by what? M. Therefore, E and E gets cancelled here. Finally, we left with what? Sigma is equals to N E square tau by M, which is an expression for what? Electrical conductivity. Which is an expression for what? Electrical conductivity. Therefore, sigma can be written as N E square tau by M. Look at the terms in electrical conductivity of a material. Electrical conductivity of a material, N stands for number of free electrons per unit volume of a conductor. N is constant for a given material. N changes when you are changing the material. Material change madre N change agutte. Otherwise the N remains what? Constant for a given material. For example, copper will be having certain value of N. Aluminium will be having certain value of N. Obviously the N is more for copper as compared to aluminium. What it means? Copper has more number of free electrons per unit volume as compared to what? Aluminium. Therefore, N is constant for a given material. N changes when you are changing the material. Okay. N is constant for a given material. E, of course, charge of electrons, it is constant. M is mass of electron, it is constant. But tau is called relaxation time. The relaxation time depends on what? Temperature. Relaxation time depends on what? Temperature. Which means electrical conductivity of a given material depends on two factors. One is N, number of free electrons per unit volume, and another one is temperature. N changes when you are changing the material. Therefore, what I can report? Electrical conductivity of a given material depends on nature of material, nature of conductor. Andre neevu copper tagondiddiro, aluminium tagondiddiro, iron tagondiddiro, gold tagondiddiro, athwa you have taken silver. Based on the material, the electrical conductivity is going to decide. Second factor is it depends on relaxation, it depends on temperature. If temperature changes, the electrical conductivity is also going to changes. How electrical conductivity changes with respect to the temperature, that discussion I will take in the next session. But as for now, tell me on what factors the electrical conductivity depends. Electrical conductivity first depends on nature of conductor, nature of material. Nature of material. Second, it depends on what? Temperature. As I said you, a reciprocal of conductivity is called resistivity. Because reciprocal of resistivity is called conductivity. Reciprocal of conductivity is called resistivity. Therefore, rho can be written as, resistivity can be written as M divided by what? N E square tau. As I said you, resistivity is also depends on nature of a material and also depends on what? Temperature. So, this is what expression for electrical conductivity of a material. This question has been asked in the previous examination for 5 mark. Annual examination, this question has been asked. So, sigma is equals to N E square tau divided by M is an expression for electrical conductivity of a material.